Now let me start a C sharp 2008 Express Edition. Now I'll just go for the file, new project. I'll name it as switch case example. Now in this demo we are going to write a program which accepts a value from the keyboard, say from 1 to 4, and depending upon the input value it is going to perform some mathematical operation. If the input value is 1, it is going to add 2 integers. If the input value is 2, it is going to subtract 2 integers. If the input value is 3, it is going to multiply the input integers. If the input value is 4, it is going to divide 2 integers. So say I have 2 integers, int a, its value is 45, and int b, say its value is 34. Now I have 2 values. Now I need to give some choices to the end user. See there, when should I use switch case? I'll be using switch cases whenever I have some multiple options in front of me and I need to go with one. So in that kind of scenarios I should have switch cases. See, I need to write a program where the end user should have multiple options. 1 for addition, 2 for subtraction, 3 for multiplication, 4 for division. So whenever I have multiple options, I need to select one, then I should go with switch cases. Same thing you might have observed when you have multiple options. Once you go for swiping your ATM card in ATM machine, it asks for saving account or current account. You say saving account, then it asks for the operation. What operation do you want to perform? Do you want to deposit the amount, withdraw the amount, or balance inquiry, or some XYZ? So you have multiple options. You go with one. You'll select one thing. So that kind of functionality, whenever you want to implement, you should go with switch cases. So here I'll just display the options first. To display the options, I should have console.writeline. One for addition, two for subtraction, three for multiplication, and 4 for division. Now whenever the end user enters any one option, either 1, 2 or 3 or 4, I need to read that option in a variable. So I'll declare a variable int ch. Ch stands for say choice. I'll be reading it from the end user. So whatever I read from the keyboard, that will be read with the help of console.readline. As we have seen in our earlier demo, I need to parse this to integers. I'll say in dot parse so that I can store the value in the integer. Fine, I'll get the choice in ch and I'll just display the choice as of now. console.write9 ch, say console.readline. See that I haven't done anything new. I have simply displayed a message and whatever the choice end user gives, I am just displaying it back on the window. Now what I want, depending upon that choice, see I have 4 cases here. I have 4 cases. Say case 1. Case 1 is addition, right? So the case 1 is something like this. console.writeline a plus b. I'll just copy this. Case 2 is a minus b. Similarly, case 3. Case 3 is a into b. I have case 4. Case 4 is a by b, and I'll typecast this if you remember from our last classes. I'll just typecast this so that I should get the exact value of a by b. Now, if the end user gives a value other than 1, 2, 3, or 4, then I should have default case. In that default, I'll say console.writeline invalid input. See that after every case, if it is case 1, it should execute this and it should break it. I'll just put a break after every case, and I need to put a break after default. See to what case it should switch and from where it should take the value. To what case, whether the case is 1, case is 2, case is 3. How does your compiler knows that what case it is? So I'll just use switch for that. I'll say that switch to ch. Now I'll just put open bracket here, close the bracket here. So my switch case looks like this. I'm giving the option in ch, it will take the value. If it is 1, it will jump to the case 1, it will execute this and it will break. As soon as it encounters this break statement, this unconditional statement, without looking for any kind of condition, it will directly jump out of the block. So it will come to console.readline. Now I'll just put a breakpoint over here. I'll just press F5 and I'll give the input as say 3. So it should jump to the multiply case. Now you check out the choice. Choice is 3, so it should jump to this case. Oh, I have pressed F5. So I'll just press enter, F5, I'll re-execute this. Case is 3, press enter and press F11. See that it has jumped to the case 3. So it will perform the multiplication operation. The value of A is 45, B is 34, A into B is 1530. Press F5, result is 1530. This is nothing but your switch case and default. I'll give some value which is out of the range. If I give 9, it should jump to the default 11. See the default input invalid input break, it will come out of the block. So this is how your switch case works. Hope you might have understood. Switch to this particular case. And one more thing, these cases need not to be in order. I can start with case 3 and I can end it with case 2. There is no problem in it. It will work fine. It should work fine. So it is giving us the subtraction result. There is no problem in it. Now instead of cases, if I want to use characters, say the special characters like this, use plus symbol for addition, minus symbol for subtraction, and say star for multiplication, divide for division. So here for the characters I need to use single quotation. Single quotation, this is multiplication, right? Single quotation star. Here I should use single quotation divide. So this is addition, right? So single quotation plus, and this is subtraction, right? So here I should use single quotation subtraction. Now whatever I am giving from the keyboard, it is a string, so I'll use string instead of that. Now I need not to parse it. I'll simply say console.readline. Whatever the characters it has read, it will store it in string. And here I think I should use double quotations, not the single quotation. No problem, let's execute this and see how it works. Now I want to perform addition. It has performed the addition operation. So that's it from switch cases. Thank you very much.